when you got the same concept for a volume, that means, well, definitely that is made up of the differential length elements. So the differential volume element for the rectangular coordinate system, what you can say, product of differential length element and differential surface element, so differential length element along x, y, and z. So product of differential length elements along x, y, and z, what it will produce? That means dx ax bar into dy ay bar into dz az bar. Definitely if it is dot product, what it becomes? The volume cannot exist because they are perpendicular. And similarly, if you take cross product, sir, we have taken our representation itself is three dimensional, but ax bar cross ay bar cross az bar becomes what, sir? Ax bar cross ay bar cross az bar means, as per the cross product formula, differential volume is dx, dy, and dz. So ax bar cross ay bar cross az bar. But we know that the cross product of this ax bar and ay bar becomes what here, sir? They will become az bar. And the other one also what becomes here? Az bar and az bar. So when you consider, sir, the cross product between az bar and az bar is again what it is becoming, az bar and az bar. Again, we have a cross product between them. When there is a cross product between az bar and az bar, the angle between them is 0. As per that, what is the sign 0 becomes here? It becomes 0. What is the sign 0 becomes here, sir? 0. So that is why, what we can say, when you consider the dot product or cross product, what is the differential value we are getting, sir? 0. So that is why, instead of taking the differential volume as a vector quantity, instead of taking term vector, sir, we'll be just taking it as a scalar. Definitely there is certain volume existing based on our what, sir? The three-dimensional coordinates x, y, and z. Three-dimensional coordinates based on x, y, and z. So, because there is certain volume based on x, y, and z, you cannot say that the volume is always zero whether you consider dot product or cross product. So that is why instead of taking it as a vector representation, sir, the differential volume can be always taken as a scalar quantity, nothing but just the product of our differential lengths, okay, without considering the notation of vectors. So it's always a scalar quantity. Is always what, sir? A scalar quantity. Yes, yes, as per our Divakar, okay, I've written, sir, it's dx, dz, ay bar. It's correct. I've just written, okay, different here. So it's made up of x and z, means dx, dz, and ay bar, okay. A small word correction over there. So differential volume is always, what, sir? Differential volume is always, okay, a scalar quantity. It's a scalar quantity. So that's how we can understand now what is rectangular coordinate system. What are the differential length elements along x, y, z? What are the differential surface elements? And what's up? What are the differential volume element? So from this, we just understand that the differential length element is a vector term. Differential surface is also what's up? A vector term. But differential volume is a scalar term. Differential volume is a scalar term. So that's how we can understand, sir, the different terms related to our rectangular coordinate system. Rectangular coordinate system. I'm just concluding all the points once again. In a rectangular coordinate system, the coordinates are x, y, z. They are represented as what's a x, y, z. And any point on the what's a, this rectangular coordinate system can be located similar to the way what we obtain for two-dimensional case. So to locate a point x1, y1, z1, one has to travel along x, what's a, along x direction, x1 units, along y direction, y1 units, along z direction, z1 units, so that one can locate the point x1, y1, z1 in a three-dimensional coordinate system. So now, what's it? Let us assume the unit vectors along x, y, z as ax bar, ay bar, az bar. And we are seeing here the different concept called the differential length elements, surface elements, and volume elements. Okay, volume elements with respect to this rectangular coordinate system. So when you look at, it means we have already understood the application of these elements is when we know the charge distribution in a smallest length, in a smallest surface, or in a smallest volume, we can evaluate what's the total charge present in the entire length or in entire surface or entire volume using the concepts of the differential length elements or surface elements or volume elements. That is why the first, okay, we are seeing what's the differential length elements. So differential length elements along x, y, z can be indicated as dx, ax bar, dy, ay bar, and dz, az bar. But differential surfaces along surface is always made up of two sides. Okay, two sides. A differential surface of along x, y direction will be what having, sir? The product of differential length elements along x and y, because they are the vector terms of differential length elements are vector terms. When you consider the product, sir, that must be a cross product. If it is a dot product, the differential surface is not existing. So we have to take it as what's a cross product. So as per the cross product, we get a convention that the differential surface can be always indicated as a differential surface and a unit normal to that surface. So based on that, we have written all differential surfaces made up of x, y will be along z direction. Differential surface made up of y, z will be along x direction. The differential surface made up of x, z will be along y direction. And that will be what's written the different what quantities related to the differential surface. Similarly, for differential volume, you cannot take a scalar, what's a vector product. If you take it as a vector product, okay, what it is happening? When you take it as a vector product, it will be what's a happening that either dot product or cross product, it will be becoming zero, but there is a finite existence of differential volume. So we'll be getting dv is equals what's a dx, dy, dz, dz. Yes, one of our student, that Thevenin. Yes, so in the case of surface dxz, so definitely it is minus ay, but you can even write what's a zx. Yes, as per the order of multiplication, yes, it becomes what's a, means as if you write xz, it is minus ay bar. If it is zx, it will be what's a, along y direction, nothing but dx, dz, ay bar. Dx, dz, ay bar, right. I hope it is clear, right, next. When you look at sir, another doubt, Nitin Goyal, so please elaborate ds bar is equals ds into an. Very simple, ds into an means when you find the differential surface, what we understand from it, always the direction of the differential surface is perpendicular to the lengths which are making that surface. Because just now we understand the differential surface along xy becomes what's here? Product of differential length elements along x and y. That means it becomes dlx into dly. But as per the cross product, what is that ax bar cross ay bar becomes az bar. But az bar is perpendicular to the xy surface. Xy surface. So, differential surface made up of any two coordinates, how we have the convention? Means the surface area, means that magnitude, into a vector which is perpendicular to that surface xy. So that is why we are writing it what's here? Az bar we got. That is why a convention that a ds bar can be written as ds into an bar. Ds into an bar. Nothing but a unit normal to this what's a surface which is making is the direction of that surface. Okay? Direction of the surface. That is why we write ds bar is equals ds into an bar. Ds into an bar. Right, sir. So this is about rectangular coordinate system. Next, okay, we have to go further. The another important one is our polar coordinate system or or cylindrical coordinate system. I'm just moving now. Okay. I hope everyone got this idea clearly. Next. But second coordinate system, sir. Our second coordinate system is nothing but cylindrical coordinate system. Cylindrical coordinate system. Or polar coordinate system. Or polar coordinate system. Right. So when you consider cylindrical, what's a coordinate system? We said for rectangular coordinate system, the coordinates are x, y, z. But when you coming towards a cylindrical coordinate system, the coordinates are, you can say r, phi, and z. In some of the books, sir, it is also indicated as rho, phi, z. rho phi z. But in our analysis, the rho we use for a different concept, okay, a different concept related towards a reflection coefficient when it comes to our wave propagation. That is why I'm just indicating, okay, means that r, the coordinate of the cylindrical instead of rho as r, r comma phi comma z. Now what is this r, sir? What is this phi and what is this z? Let us see now, okay. So basically what we are saying, it's a cylindrical coordinate system. Look at this, sir. I'm just drawing. So our reference is as our rectangular or Cartesian coordinate system. When you look at the first term, that is r, here r is called the radius of the cylinder. That means, as the name itself indicates, in our coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system, we have to consider a cylindrical surface first. From that, we understand what are these coordinates, what's r, phi, z. Now I am considering a cylindrical surface, whose axis as z axis, that means our cylindrical surface center is passing through what's z axis. That's our origin is nothing but its center. So now, let's say its radius is r. Its radius, what's I am considering it as r. That is nothing but our first coordinate of cylindrical coordinate system. Means in cylindrical coordinate system, r indicates the radius of the cylinder, a radius of the cylindrical surface. Right. Next, phi. So what is this phi? If you see, very simple. Phi is an angle made which is perpendicular to xy plane, with respect to xz plane, which is called what, sir, here? Phi, angle phi, which is also called azimuthal angle, So once again, listen, how do we say angle phi? It is a half plane angle, or it's half plane angle which is perpendicular to xy, with respect to xz plane. Is called what, sir, here? Phi, which is called phi here. Nothing but azimuthal angle we call it as. Similarly, now look at the z. Z is nothing but our normal what, sir? Z-axis with respect to our rectangular coordinate system, we can call it as what's a z-coordinate. So when we consider cylindrical what's a surface, basically the two coordinates we have to understand which are different from our rectangular, that is r is nothing but radius of cylinder, phi is the angle what's a perpendicular to xy plane with respect to what's a xz plane, which we are calling it as azimuthal angle, So these are what's the coordinates of cylindrical coordinate system, which are called r, phi and z, Now let us what's try to understand what are the differential length elements, again similar to the way what we have seen before, differential length elements, differential surface elements and differential volume elements for this, okay, So let us what's that means phi is between x axis and radius r. Yes, sir, exactly. The phi is taken, in the direction of r, as per one of the student out Partha. So because it, we are taking one of this what side is perpendicular to the xy plane. In the direction of r itself, yes. Now let us obtain, a differential length elements along r, phi and z directions. So first of all, let us assume, sir, the unit vectors along r, phi, z, the unit vector along r direction. I am taking it as a r bar, let us say. The unit vector along phi direction, let's say I am taking a phi bar. the unit vector along z direction, let's say I'm taking az bar. Now let us try to get the differential length elements related to this, it's a cylindrical coordinate system. So the first one, I'm writing differential length element along r direction. Differential length element along r direction, sir, because radius is also a length, you can just write, okay, differential length element along r, as what's the smallest part of it, let's say I'm taking dr a r bar. Differential length element along r direction is what's dr a r bar. Next, differential length element along phi direction. Differential length element along phi direction. We know that phi is an angle. Means if you want to obtain a differential length along phi direction, means a differential length here, what stands for the length along r direction itself. The length along r direction itself. Because phi is obtained along what's here? R direction here. That means a differential length along phi, we cannot say simply d phi. A differential length, okay, element along phi, we cannot say simply d phi, because d phi is a differential, what's the angle, differential length, differential change in angle. But we are talking about differential length along phi direction. So differential length element along phi direction is related to along what's the r itself. That means we can say differential length along what's the, this is nothing but r itself here. You can say differential length along phi direction is nothing but r d phi a phi bar. R d phi a phi bar. Right. Again, one of students, Kundan. Look at this here. How this phi, means this direction, is perpendicular to xy. When you look at this, is what's a side. You can see this is our side, which is making what's a, this xy into two planes. And how can you see this x direction of this radius, sir, with respect to phi? It is perpendicular to x and y. It is perpendicular to x and y. That's why we say, means phi is an angle. Means this side is perpendicular to x and y. But not phi is perpendicular to x and y. Phi is an angle with which, okay, means we are getting, means of this xy plane is divided into two parts. XY plane is divided into two parts. But this direction of this side is perpendicular to the x and y, but not phi. But not phi is making this, what's a side, to be perpendicular to x and y. X and y, yes. Now, so differential length element along phi direction, as Saurav wants once again. See, we want differential length along phi direction. See, if I cannot say differential length element along phi direction as simply d phi a phi bar. Because phi is an angle here. Phi is an angle here. Means, when we have a d phi change in angle, what is the change in, what's the length we get along that phi direction? When we have a change in phi angle, when we have a change in phi angle, what is the change that results in, what's the length? Due to the change in d phi, we call differential length along phi. That is why the differential length along phi means nothing but what is this, what beside the phi is making along what's a r itself. The phi is making along r itself. So that's why what we are writing, the differential length along phi is nothing but what's a, due to that r, I can write as r d phi a phi bar. But we cannot simply say d phi a phi bar. That gives just the change in angle, the differential angle, but not the differential length due to the change in angle. So the differential length due to the change in angle, how much we can say? R d phi a phi bar. R d phi a phi bar. Similarly, the differential length along z direction. The differential length along z direction. It is similar to our, what's our rectangular coordinate system. That means you can say differential length along z direction, we can write it as what's a dz a z bar. Dz a z bar. Directly. Because just the differential length along z direction, nothing but dz a z bar. So that's how, sir, we can understand the differential length along r direction, because the radius is a length. A differential length, you can indicate dr a y, okay, a r bar. And differential length along phi, the phi is taken with respect to what's r here, or means in the direction of r. So we can say r d phi a phi bar. And differential length along z becomes dz az bar. Dz az bar. Now, the total differential length element for cylindrical coordinate system is a vector sum of all these three. The total differential length element, what's about the cylindrical coordinate system, is a vector sum of all these three. That means it becomes now, this becomes now, tell me what you can see here, dr ar bar plus r d phi a phi bar plus dz az bar, dz az bar. So this is called what's the total differential, okay, length element for cylindrical coordinate system or polar coordinate system. Next. So we have defined what's the differential length elements. Similar to the way what we have seen for differential surface elements of our rectangular coordinate system, let us obtain the differential surface elements, okay, made up of these coordinates r, phi and z. So definitely we know that what's the differential surface is made up of what's the two coordinates, okay, means made up of two lengths here. So you can obtain the differential surface along r direction, differential surface along phi direction, differential surface along z direction with the help of the differential length elements, okay, with the help of differential length elements. As per the convention what we have seen before, we know that any differential surface can be written as differential surface is equals the differential surface area into, okay, unit normal to that surface, okay. Now let us write what's here, the differential surface along r direction I want, let's say along r direction. That means differential surface along r direction means our unit normal becomes r direction. It is made up of the other two lengths. What are the other two lengths here? The other two lengths other than r is nothing but what's a differential length along phi and differential length along z. That means product of these two lengths and the vector is along r direction as per the convention an bar. So differential surface made up of phi and z will be along r direction. Made up of phi and z will be along r direction. So differential surface along r direction, we can write the product of the differential lengths. That means you can say dl phi into dlz into ar bar. Into ar bar. So this becomes, what is actually dl phi, sir? r d phi and dz ar bar is the differential surface along r direction. Differential surface along r direction for cylindrical coordinate system. Similarly, the differential surface along, let us say phi direction, I'm saying differential surface along what's a phi direction. So it is made up of what, sir? Means here the direction is along phi. It is made up of the other two lengths along r and along z. So we can say it is a product of a differential length element along r and z, nothing but dr dz, but the direction is along what's a phi here. Similarly, the differential surface along z direction means it is made up of the differential length elements along r and phi. That means it becomes here r dr d phi a z bar. R dr d phi a z bar is nothing but differential surface along z direction. That's how we can define what, sir? All the three surfaces along, okay, r and along phi and along z. And anyhow, we know that the differential volume element is just a scalar. Just multiply all the three differential lengths, you'll be getting the differential volume related to our cylindrical coordinate system. Differential volume related to our cylindrical coordinate system. So it becomes now our dv is equals product of all the three differential lengths. Nothing but you'll be getting here, what's the first I'm writing is r dr d phi dz is nothing but the differential volume of a cylindrical coordinate system. That's how we can, what's the define the differential length elements, differential surface elements and differential volume elements of a cylindrical coordinate system. And we can understand what are the, what's the coordinates of that cylindrical also, like r, phi, z. Now, let us try to establish the relation between our, what, rectangular coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system. Rectangular coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system. Let's see, sir, how we are deriving. Okay. Look at this. Look at what, sir? This representation. From this representation, let's once again, I'm drawing, sir, otherwise. X, Y, and Z. Let us say we just located a point, so here, assume X, Y, Z, by traveling along X units, sir, along X direction as X units, and along Y direction as Y units, and similarly along Z direction as Z units. Z units. So now I'm just indicating those lengths like this. Try to understand clearly. Let's say this, and let's say saying Y. This length, let us say, is Y, sir. This is nothing but X. And so this is nothing but, okay, Z. This is nothing but Z. This length is Z. Now, as for the cylindrical coordinates, now how we have, sir, phi? So this is our what, sir? We said R. This is basically R. And this angle, we have called it as phi. This angle, we have called it as phi. Now, let us try to, what, sir, apply. Okay? Means cos of the angle or sine of the angle to get the relation between what, sir? Phi and X and Y and Z. Okay? And R also. Now, first, when I apply here, sir, definitely, because I said this is what's a perpendicular to the X and Y. So, I can call this a right angle triangle. Okay? This can call a right angle triangle. Definitely, what's a, this, okay, looks like a hypotenuse having longest side. Okay? Longest side. So, when we apply here, cos of the angle phi, cos phi, what it will produce, sir? Cos phi is nothing but adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. That means, what is adjacent side length here? X. Hypotenuse becomes what, sir? R. So, what is our X becomes now? Our X becomes here R cos phi. That's how we can express our rectangular coordinate X in terms of cylindrical coordinates R and phi. R and phi. So, that's why we say relation X is equals here R cos phi. Similarly, apply sine of the angle, so here. Apply sine of the angle. Sine phi is equals the opposite side by hypotenuse. What is the opposite side becomes here? Y by hypotenuse. What is that hypotenuse here, sir? R. That means what is our Y becomes now? Our Y becomes now R sine phi. Y is equals R sine phi. So, which is called what, sir, here? Again, the another coordinate, rectangular coordinate Y, is written in terms of our cylindrical coordinates R and phi. When you look at z-axis is similar in the case of our what, sir? Cylindrical coordinate system, or in the case of our Cartesian coordinate system. Because I said coordinates while saying cylindrical, R is the radius of the cylinder and phi is the what, sir? Angle which is made by what, sir? XZ plane with XY plane, which is perpendicular to XY plane. And Z is a just Z coordinate. Or I said, sir, simply, while saying R is the radius of the cylinder whose axis is same as Z axis. That means our Z axis in both the coordinate system will be similar. So, that's why we can say the third coordinate, our Z is equals Z. Z is equals Z. That's how we can understand, okay, the relation between what, sir? Cylindrical and rectangular coordinate system. By having relation, what we got? X is equals R cos phi, Y is equals R sin phi, and Z is equals Z. That means in this relation, we expressed our rectangular coordinates in terms of cylindrical coordinates. We can also express, sir, in the reverse way. That means we can express our R phi Z also in terms of X, Y, Z. So how I am doing that, sir? Further, let's see. I'm just following this, okay, procedure. I'm just simplifying those what relations to get our what's the other relation. Let's see how I'm taking. So because we got X is equals R cos pi and Y is equals R sin pi. I'm just squaring both. x square is equals becomes what here, sir? R square cos square phi. And y square becomes what here, sir? R square sine square phi. I'm just adding both. Let's see what you get now. X square plus y square is equals R square cos square phi plus R square sine square phi. R square cos square phi plus R square sine square phi. So when you take what's here, let's say R square common, it becomes now cos square phi plus sine square phi. As per the what's the trigonometric properties, this value becomes 1. Nothing but you can say, it is nothing but simply R square. So x square plus y square is equals R square, and R is equals here becomes square root of x square plus y square. That's how we can express our R in terms of x and y. Before we have seen our x and y are expressed in terms of R phi. Now our R is expressed in terms of x, y using this what's a relation. Similarly, now let us get phi, the other coordinate phi, in terms of x and y. So here we got x is equals r cos phi and y is equals r sin phi. Just do y by x. Y by x is equals, what do you get here, sir? Nothing but r sin phi divided by r cos phi. R gets cancelled. And sin phi by cos phi becomes here tan phi is equals y by x. So now what is phi becomes here? Phi becomes here tan inverse of y by x. So that's how we can say, sir, even the other relation phi expressed in terms of y and x. And anyhow, cylindrical z is equals our what's a rectangular z. And that's how we can even see the reverse relation also, where our cylindrical coordinates are expressed in terms of rectangular. And in the beginning, we have seen what's our rectangular coordinates in terms of our cylindrical coordinate system. That is how we can understand relation between our rectangular coordinates and cylindrical coordinates. So this is about what, sir, means. This is about our cylindrical coordinate system, about differential length elements, differential surface elements, and differential volume elements, and the relationship between Cartesian and rectangular coordinate systems. Right. So this is about our second. Now let us move on to our last and the next coordinate system. Okay, next coordinate system is nothing but spherical coordinate system. Our next one is spherical coordinate system. I hope everyone got the idea related to these, okay, or means their relation between what's the different coordinate systems also. I'm just removing it, sir, now. So before we begin, let's break for 5 minutes and then, okay, come back to the spherical coordinate system.